And now we're sitting here with, I have to lean forward because it's the lean forward moment with the legend himself, Norm Hollyn. Hey,
oh,
Norm. I feel
you.
Like I should just hand you the mic and let you talk yourself.
Oh, no, you
such
don't want to do that.
Guy.
Take it back.
No, I watch it here on YouTube, and you're very good on camera, sir.
Well, thank you very
much. As well
much.
As being a very fantastic editor and everything.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you for that.
I put very badly.
But those, no, but actually I think you're right, because those two things are connected, the way in which you can push who you are, to use social media, establish. I mean, you know this, right?
Yes, yes.
You're there
I
consistently.
Have a blog now, yeah.
You give good value to people, tell them things that they want to hear, and as a result, people begin to know who you are in a broader circle, right?
Right, right.
See, I think actually part of what we have to do as editors,
right.
And we're so damn bad at it, is to take ownership of how good we can be and to let other people know that.
Of your work, which is what we're doing here on the Stephen Holt Show today and at EditFest itself, which is to bring a higher profile to editors and show everyone that you put in as much work as everyone else does, and are just as talented and interesting and glamorous as everyone else. Behind.
Yes, we are. Yes, right.
And of course, you have these wonderful panels every year about the Lean Forward moment, which, as you said,
right.
Well, you can talk about that. You have a book called The Lean Forward Moment.
Right, and in the Lean Forward Moment, it's not just focused on editing. What the Lean Forward Moment does is it starts with the idea that we, as people, worldwide, doesn't matter what culture we're in, react when things change. Up on the screen, right? So
right.
So that's when we pay a little bit more attention. That's when inside we lean forward and go, when we cut from a wide to a close-up, when we introduce a piece of music that hasn't been there before, when we drop sound out, when we change the pacing, when an actor stands up as opposed to see. When those things change, we inside lean forward and pay more attention as an audience. So that's cool. That's a great device
and
for
always
us now to
forward
do
forward when you're talking.
Well, thank you. That means I am sucking you in,
yes,
right?
Yes, I'm sucked in here today on the Stephen Holt Show. Norm, if people want to find you on like YouTube and all the fabulous things you talk about and do, it's your last name is spelled
Hollyn, Hollyn,
which we'll put up right here.
That's
right.
Right
yeah,
here.
Yeah, and
And on a lot of the stuff that you'll see on YouTube is I do in partnership with a guy named Larry Jordan.
That's right.
Right,
that's
and we
right.
do
Thank
something
you.
Called Two Real Guys.
That's right. That's what I was watching.
And that's how you understand how you can tell better stories. We don't tell which buttons to push. We say, why would you push that button as opposed to the other one? So I'm passionate about helping people to tell better stories. That's what the book is about.
And
that's
where
what
can
Two Real
people
Guys
get
about.
The book if they want to get the Lean Forward? We should have a book to hold up a copy, but we don't.
Oh, right. I only have, I have a second book that I wrote, which is called The Film Editing Room Handbook. And
you have that. No,
no, but that the Lean Forward Moment, best place.
Sold out.
That's right. The best place to get the Lean Forward Moment is on Amazon.
Okay,
so
Amazon.com.
look for me, look for Lean Forward Moment, and Amazon.com is the cheapest place to get it and the most reliable.
Okay.
Or you could pay more money and go to my publisher.
Oh, okay.
Peach Pit Press, you could do that too. Peach Pit Press. They do some awesome, awesome books, and I'm very fortunate to be with them. So, so I mean, basically that whole concept of the panels that I run here at EditFest.
Yeah,
and this is the
now.
Third year that I've done it here in New York.
Go Norm.
So long as people want to come.
So impressive and dazzling.
You
know,
get some, the idea is to get amazing people up there who've done wide variety of things, right? So we had Lance Edmonds there this year, who is a young editor who did Tiny Furniture. He's directing his own thing now. And some of the stuff he said just blew my mind.
Like what, for instance?
He was talking about how to look at works of art, he said, keep challenging yourself. Work, do things that are different than what your comfort zone is.
Right.
And then you'll be better as an editor.
Right.
And it's like, wow, absolutely.
Right. Well, as a film critic and a theater critic, I'm often forced to see things that
yes.
I...
out of your comfort zone.
Yes, yes. Right. Whether I like it or not, I got it. Mm-hmm. I won't mention the film since, but I'm like, right. Am I going to like this? And sometimes you ended up loving it, and right. Sometimes you're right in the first place. But it's work, so you have to see it.
Well, but I think the point that you raise is a good one, that we never quite know
when we go in,
how we're going to react to something.
Right.
So sometimes our suspicions are confirmed, but often they're not. And
I love to be surprised. I try not to read any production notes.
Me too.
I want to go in like Joe Q.
I don't even read reviews. Don't even let me know anything. But that if we go with our preconceptions and don't go to something, we miss the opportunity to learn something new, right?
Right.
So,
right.
So I think what Lance said about pushing your own expectations, about challenging them all the time, is so right on.
Well, I'll just mention something that I wasn't particularly looking forward to seeing. I still haven't seen it, but I'm going to, is Prometheus, which ends up being, and yes, I do read people's reviews sometimes, a career thing for my friend Noomi Rapace, who's making all the dragon tattoo Swedish films, is putting them all in the shade, evidently, with this. With Prometheus, and my friend Logan Marshall Green is playing her husband. I got to see this now because they're both in it. I was coming home from EditFest last night, and I was walking by one of the theaters that was showing.
It opened this weekend, yes.
Yes. But every performance sold out. Uh-oh, I better see this one.
That's
every
right.
There wasn't
gotcha. Until the meantime, this is what I'm doing when people say, well, I saw this movie, I loved it.
It's well, you know, you can sort of get a consensus, you know, like if everybody's saying they hated it, probably you will too, you know,
I worked on the movie Heathers, and when Heathers came out, there were people who loved it and people who hated it.
Right.
And that's, for me, the best films to work on. The ones where no one's kind of in the middle going, yeah, kind of like that or whatever. But the ones where people go, I love that. No, you're an idiot. That kind of thing. The ones that bring emotions to the surface, that means you're really affecting someone.
Well, last,
so I'd like to work on those.
Well, last year you told our viewers that they had to see Midnight in Paris, and of course, I've seen it now 10 times.
Oh, right.
But, and you were talking about, you know, the Oscars this year, last year, and of course, The Artist wasn't even at that time on anybody's radar, nobody knew.
Right.
And this year, I don't know, it's kind of...
We'll find out. Well, I love Moonrise Kingdom.
Oh, but I haven't seen that
yet.
Right,
because I'm always surprised and pleased by the way in which his characters reveal themselves.
Okay.
And I'm a character
driven
person.
Me too. So, I'm a character, okay? Yeah.
That's right. And I want to see the movie about you.
Oh, I do too. I think we're filming it right now.
Oh, God.
He's collecting footage.
I'm just
Kevin.
A co-star.
Right.
It's an old story. Right?
And I'm on the Norm Hollyn show today.
Oh, God.
You know, you're really good at this, and it's always a delight to talk to you.
Well,
And thank you for taking time away from the busy raffle upstairs that's going on. Somebody's winning, I don't know.
Someone's winning a copy of Avid Media Composer
and
upstairs.
And what is that?
It's how we edit.
Oh.
Most high-end features, television, even indie movies, will use its Avid Media Composer or Final Cut. Or Adobe, but Avid's mostly
and the media
used on the
like
high
this.
End.
It's like the whole.
It's a piece of software that sits on your computer
it's
that
the
enables
whole
you to edit everything.
Enchilada,
That's right. Well, in French we don't call it that.
Right.
In English we don't call it that. But like, yes, it's get the movie in here and then
get
all the footage here and then I'll get the movie out to you.
Okay. So, great. Well, somebody's upstairs winning that, but we're. Winning today with the winning personality.
We're just
of
here
Norm.
In the Stephen Holt story.
Yeah. Okay. Have a fabulous. Thank you, Norm.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Great.